afternoon, everybody. Welcome to your glorious Wednesday afternoon Devo, your days of your daily bread passage, and your bonus Devo, which I'll get to that in just a few minutes. But your daily bread regular passage, we're going to be talking about Lion, Lamb, Savior. Lion, comma, Lamb, comma, Savior, exclamation point. From James Banks, like Banks of the River, derived from Revelation 5, 1 through 7. So if you're excited about another Hump Day Wednesday afternoon, smash that like button, comment something. Let me change it up just a little bit. Comment something that you wish somebody well in 22. What is something that you wish another person will be able to accomplish in the new year? Just change it up a little bit. But also, what are you looking forward to in 22? Trying getting a brand new start on or something. What's coming up in the next few weeks that you're looking forward to? If there's an event or something that's happening in January, are you looking forward to that or something else? Are you looking forward to helping a friend or family member out in the month of January? Just put that in the comment section and I'll be sure to respond in a polite way. But subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach that goal of 100 subscribers, and which if I could get 25 to 50 by January 15th, which is 17 days, I will be more than happy if I could just get it to 25 to 50 subscribers. Because I know it's been a short, I've been trying for a couple months now to get it to 100. And when I started, I wanted to get to 1,000, but then I shortened it to 100, but now looks like I'm not going to be able to get 100. But if I could get at least 25 to 50, anywhere in that number, at least 25, if not 50, by the 15th, then I'll be happy. That gives us 2 days left in 2021. And then we turn around and say, hello, 2022, Friday at midnight. So, but without further ado, let's get to the Days of Praise passage, or the Daily Bread passage, excuse me. Lion, comma, Lamb, comma, Savior, exclamation point. From James Banks, derived from Revelation 5, 1 through 7. And it is your episode 583, part 2, for Wednesday, December 29th? Yeah. But James writes, two stately stone lions watch over the entrance to the New York Public Library. I've seen pictures of it. Pretty nice. It'd be nice to see them in person one day. Hewn from marble, they stood there proudly since the library's dedication in 1911. They were first nicknamed Leo Lennox and Leo Astor to honor the library's founders. But during the Great Depression, the New York's mayor, Ferrello LaGuardia, renamed them Fortitude and Patience. Virtues he thought New Yorkers should demonstrate in those challenging years. The lions are still called Fortitude and Patience to this day. And also something else I would like to see in New York is the zoo. The Central Park Zoo, the Bronx Zoo, all those are all connected. I would love to see the main, I think it's Central Park, it's either Central Park or the Bronx, where they've got the one big building with the animals carved on the side of the building. I would like to see that building one day. And if I ever get to Nashville and get my music career going, if I can ever get there, Lord willing, I'll be able to, I'm planning on doing a concert in Central Park. I have ideas of doing a concert in Central Park and raising the funds for animal organizations around the world. which is a good idea. But one of the organizations will be that New York, that Central Park Zoo, and all the surrounding zoos that are thing. I just have to get up there, go in and talk to the big man. And you can see that zoo on the Animal Planet station when you watch the series The Zoo. You can see the behind the scenes of that zoo, and it is amazing what they do. And that building is right there at the beginning when it first come on, and you'll see that building I'm talking about. So it's an amazing architecture. And I would love to see it in person. And I want to go up there and talk to the big man and bring up that observation about the concert and see what he said. See what he could set up with some other animal organizations like the SPCA, the World Wildlife Fund, some of these other animal leagues that need help. The money will be raised and split between all of them. Everybody will get an even amount of money. Hopefully what we raise. And hopefully if we get the word out about it enough, we can get a lot of supporters donating a lot of extra funds and supplies and stuff that they need. And we can get a real good turnout. And my original plans for this is a lot of plans to move to Nashville, become a singer, become good friends with Tim McGraw and Faith Hill, and be good friends with them. They come up and help with the comp. They come up and sing, and then I come up there and sing, or I'll come up there and sing because I'm the rookie. I'll be the rookie, but then they could come up and do sets of their own. And have a few songs of duets together, and we can sit there and I can live stream it on Facebook and YouTube, and everything, and the different aspects. There'd be a phone number that's put on the screen that people can call. They can go online and donate online and do everything, but. It's something else. So, but sorry about getting off subject. I haven't even. Oh, I have read a little bit, but let's get back to it. Sorry for rambling for a few minutes, but that'd be a good that's a good dream that I want to aim for to be able to do one day, Lord willing. So, but the Bible describes a living, powerful lion who also gives encouragement in trouble and is known by other names. In his vision of heaven, the Apostle John wept when he saw that no one was able to open the sealed scroll containing God's plan of judgment and redemption. Then John was told, "Do not weep. See, the Lion of the tribe of Judah has triumphed. He is able to open the scroll and its seven seals," in Revelation 5, verse 5. So yet in the very next verse, in verse 6, John describes something else entirely. "Then I saw a lamb, looking as if it had been slain, standing at the center of the throne." So first off, you talk about the lion, then you talk about a lamb. The lion and the lamb are the same person, Jesus. He is the conquering king and the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. John 1:29. Through his strength and his cross, we receive the mercy and forgiveness so that we may live in joy and wonder at all he is forever. Our loving Savior. Lion, Lamb, Savior. All in one. So what's your favorite name for Jesus? What aspects of his character makes you want to praise him most? And once again, observational answers in the comments if you feel free to do so. You don't have to. It's just optional. But ponder that by saying, "Beautiful Savior, I could praise you for all eternity and never come to the end of all that you are. Thank you for giving yourself for me so that I may live in your love forever." So your Bible reading for this one is Zechariah 9 through 12 and Revelation 20. Oh, Revelation 20. So, still got like two more days. So, each day is So coming up in tomorrow's part two, which will there will be no bonus after tomorrow's part two, but Thursday, December 30th, we're gonna be part two of episode 584. Yeah, 584. Because I started with two yesterday and three today, so 82 yesterday and 83 today, so it'd be 84 part two. So we're going to be talking about Better Than Gold from Patricia Rayburn, derived from Proverbs 3, 13 through 18. So stay tuned to that. I'll get to that in a couple days, sometime today. I'll get to those Thursday and Friday, finish it up. And maybe even do Saturdays, because I have a big prop for Saturday's videos. So, just stay tuned for that. And I may even get up and do a live stream and put both of them together and say, hey, Happy New Year. But I have something. But your 10th and final reflection in the 10 reflections, your Celebrating Jesus book, your 10 Christmas reflections on Christ and community from the Daily Bread book, Daily Bread People. The 10th and final one is O Come Emmanuel from Bill Crowder. Colossians 3, 12 through 15 is your passage, and your key verse is verse 15. Let the peace that comes from Christ rule in your hearts, for as members of one body, you are called to live in peace. So Bill writes, it seems we seldom go beyond the first or second verses of our beloved Christmas carols. But buried deep in the lyrics of one Christmas hymn in verse 7, didn't know it had that many verses, are the words that seem uniquely in tune with our times. O come, Emmanuel, written in the 12th century, which pleads, O King of nations, bind and won the hearts of all mankind. Bid all our sad divisions cease and be yourself our King of Peace. So I can't imagine a more appropriate prayer for our fractious splintered generation. With the tone of public debate and private disagreement of what seems to be an all-time high for anger and aggression, how desperately need the King of Peace to come to our help. So the sad divisions we exhibit in our communities, churches, workplaces, relationships, and families can only be overcome with the help of the one who came to forgive, heal, and restore. No wonder Isaiah anticipated the coming Jesus by calling him Prince of Peace in Isaiah 9:6 again. So the Apostle Paul urges us to put this into practice. Let the peace that comes from Christ rule in your hearts, he wrote. For as members of one body, you are called to live in peace, which is that key verse, verse 15. So as we allow this peaceful Prince to restore our relationships, we ourselves become agents of his peace. Amen? So lastly, where do I see broken relationships or devised behavior in my life? Where do you see broken relationships or divine behavior in your lives? Why do you need to ask for forgiveness for my contribution to the breakdown? And why is it so important to seek reconciliation with others? And once again, feel free to answer those questions in the comments. You don't have to if you don't want to. So, but ponder those questions by saying this. Father, I thank you for sending the Prince of Peace to rescue us. Help us experience his peace not only in our hearts, but also in our relationships. Enable us to be peacemakers who are agents of his peace, providing love. And that is your last reflection of the 10 reflections of Christ in the Celebrating Jesus Christmas book. And then that's the cover. But day one, we had a Down Under Christmas from Lisa M. Samrock. Day two, we had a Table for All, Wynn Collier. Joy to the World was day three, Po Fang Chia. Day four, we had Dreaming at Christmas, which was Christmas Eve. That was Thursday. Day five was Mission Impossible, which was Christmas Eve. Day six was The True Gift of Christmas, which was Christmas Day. Day seven was Captain of a Motley Crew from Glenn Packiam. Wait a minute, let me go back. Dreaming at Christmas Day 4 was Tim Gustafson. Mission Impossible was James Banks on Day 5. Day 6 was A True Gift of Christmas from Amy Boucher Pye on Christmas. Then Sunday, Day 7 was Captain of a Motley Crew from Glenn Packiam. Day 8 was Mary New from Dave Brennan. Day 9 was Through the Tears, which was yesterday, from Zotchel E. Dixon. And that today was O Come Emmanuel from Bill Crowder. So, I trust that you would hope, and sorry for the longer video than usual. Trust you've hope you have seen all 10 reflections. If you haven't, go back and watch the part 2 for the last 10 days. Today and in the last 9 days. And you'll have to skip through the Daily Bread passage just to get to the bonus devos. But there's no bonus tomorrow, so. But coming up in your Wednesday turning point for December 29th, episode 123, we're going to be talking about Spirit of the Mind, beginning with Ephesians 4:23. Your recommended reading is Romans 12, 1 and 2, which is about making your bodies a living sacrifice, that passage. There is a footnote from the second passage, the second paragraph on this page, from the guy with the turning point, Jeremiah Johnston, PhD. There's an excerpt from an article that he wrote, or part of the article from... piece of the article he wrote is that second paragraph. So I'll read that further in the next video, so in the upcoming video. So, but until then, I love you and I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Sorry for the longer video than usual, but I got to rambling there at the beginning, so that's the reason why we had a longer video. But sorry about that, but hope you stuck through. If you haven't smashed that like button, smash it, please, if you stuck it through this long. And, I love you and I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trust in God, and He'll keep you safe in all you say and do. And until later, peace out, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your Hump Day Wednesday afternoon. Come back this evening for the Spirit of the Mind. Your turning point Devo for after 7. And I'll see everybody then, hopefully.